As we traveled up the Neosho River with the wind at our face and the roar of the boat, the excitement was building. My paddle fishing adventure was at hand. Compared to regular fishing, though, I know there are a lot of differences, yet the basics are the same. You need a reel, a rod, and a hook.
We are snagging today. We're not trying to get this fish to bite it. We're just trying to cast this out here, bring it over to somebody, and snag the fish. So it's a little bit different.
So with an 8-foot rod, a big spinning reel, a 30-pound line, big treble hook, and a 3-ounce weight, I was ready to go.
And these fish will be coming up and down the river as they spawn this time of year. So we're just going to cast out there and make nice, smooth sweeps and try to catch a fish.
And try we did for several hours, but unfortunately, it just wasn't meant to be today. Paddlefish average around 30 pounds, but can go up to 70 and 80 and higher. Even though there's low water this year, March, April, and May are the ideal times for catching them. And the perfect and best place to do so is northeastern Oklahoma.
It's quite the tourist destination. We like to say we have a blue ribbon paddlefish fishery here. So we attract people from all 50 states, including other countries. We do a survey where we've learned a lot of this, and if you look around at the boat ramps, you see lots of out-of-state anglers coming to Oklahoma to catch paddlefish.
Take, for instance, Andrew from Joplin, Missouri. He's been coming here for 20 years and loves the challenge of paddle fishing.
Sometimes you get a good one that fights really good, and then other ones, you know, feels like basically like a log that you can film when you hook them and they, you know, wiggle a little bit.
It's a heavy fish. It's tough to bring in. That's why we have such stout gear. But it's a good time. We see a lot of smiles out here when we're running up and down the river talking to anglers from out of state. And they're just happy. Even if they're not catching fish, they're happy to be here. So we appreciate it.
And here's something that anglers appreciate.
If they are lucky enough to hook a paddlefish, our boats, we call it the paddle ship, will come pick up that fish for them. They'll bring it to our research processing center.
The research center was created in 2008, and when the paddlefish arrive, the staff, much like a well-synchronized dance, kick into high gear. Once here, they tag the fish with a barcode, all the data is uploaded, the fish is weighed and measured, then once in the back, they begin the fillet process, rinse and package it for the angler to pick up later. If the fish has roe or eggs, they are removed and processed into caviar.
American paddlefish create a caviar that is similar tasting and can be bought at a much cheaper price. It's an inexpensive substitute for that beluga caviar. We've had several people that taste it say they like it just as well.
The initial time from having the eggs removed to packaged caviar is around 30 minutes. Now, this center is regulated by the FDA and the health department. They take great steps in keeping everything clean, so in the back you have to wear face masks, hairnets, and before entering, your shoes have to be sanitized. Now, the money from the caviar funds the research center and helps the wildlife department pay for other projects as well. And to have anglers come from all over to fish right here is a huge bonus, just like Bill Leffler from Nebraska.
It's the only spot I've ever snagged for spoonbill, and I'd say it's probably one of the best spots in the world. It's been real good. The processing center's a big plus because I don't have to clean the fish.